Welcome back to the Mr. Showtym Showcast. Two things can be true at once. And today, I'm going to be talking about the chronicles of a proud nationalist. Ladies and gentlemen, in the whole school education system, we've been told half-truths and half-lies, which essentially is not really the truth, okay? Here's how Hollywood movies such as The Boy in the Striped Pyjamas and The Inside Man starring Denzel Washington and Clive Owen. Now, credit to the movie directors and producers of, you know, these Hollywood films, because the depiction and the storytelling is very ingenious. Hollywood is owned and run by, you know, the Jewish Zionists, such as Harvey Weinstein, for example. Jews are a very dangerous group of people. I like to call them the Agent Smiths, you know, to avoid censorship on, you know, on this particular platform on YouTube. Jews are very dangerous because they run everything. And I mean everything, okay? They're a very powerful group of people. And for the longest time, they have programmed a lot of people to sympathize with, you know, the Jewish supremacy, to just embrace Jewish supremacy and not call anything into question. And if you do, you know, oh, that means you must be a terrible, evil, bad person. An anti-Semite, so to speak. Most people have been so psyoped and programmed into sympathizing with Jews to the point where just talking about it just makes people's skin crawl. It makes their hair at the back of their necks stand. I was over at certain platforms, at certain panels, and we're talking about, you know, how, you know, the events during the Holocaust. And people, their default programming is just to push back and say, no, Adolf Hitler was an evil man. He needed and as much as you can try to break it down to them to say that, look, Adolf Hitler did what he did for a reason. Now, personally, I don't agree with his methods of, you know, deleting more or less 6 million Jews by means of putting them in gas chambers and gassing them. I don't believe in that particular method, but hey, you know, the world was very savage and it was a different time prior to World War II. The world was completely different. The world was savage. I mean, there's certain words people used to say back in the day that you can't say today. There's certain phrases and words and descriptions of certain people that they used to use back in the day that, you know, today would be considered hate speech. I'm not saying it's right, I'm not saying it's wrong, I'm just telling you how it is. The world was different, it was a different time. Okay? So, you know, it's just really like scary how people who are not even Jewish, they'll just have this, like, this default automatic response of defending the Jews. When clearly, they don't know the reasons why Hitler did what he did. In schools, we were taught that Hitler was a bad person and, you know, he just had this insatiable hatred for Jews, and that's how he knows his framing, because words are powerful. They told us that Hitler blamed Jews for Germany's economic downfall. They didn't tell us that Jews were engaging in certain agendas that contributed, that caused Germany's economic downfall. So do you see how taking out certain words changes the whole paradigm of a narrative? So instead of saying Hitler realized how Jews were engaging in certain agendas or causing the downfall of Germany's economy, they say that Hitler blamed Jews for Germany's economic downfall. Just that subtle switch in the sentence just changes the perception of everything. Isn't it funny how you'll be hard pressed to go to Germany and find someone who's related to Hitler? Not even someone who's related to Hitler, someone who has the same surname as Hitler. You'd be hard pressed to find that person. Because trust and believe, Hitler still has, I'm sure he does, family members or people that are related to him by blood, either in Germany or in Austria or in Switzerland, what have you, right? So this is why, folks, we need to protect our First Amendment, because words are powerful. Words shape the entire fate of a nation or the world. Now, coming back to Hollywood movies such as, you know, The Boy in the Striped Pyjamas. I was in primary when they played that movie for us. And of course, the movie is very touching. It is very touching. It is a movie about, you know, a German kid who made friends with a Jewish kid. And they were separated by a mere fence. The German kid was privileged, came from a stable family, like I did. The reason why I just wanted to, you know, sprinkle that in there, because I am not a relatable person, considering, you know, I'm a black person. It is super rare to come across, you know, ones like me. You know, I've been told so many times that, you know, I speak so well and yada yada yada. That's because it's rare in the black community, and people love an underdog story. I am not an underdog story. I'm not a relatable person. But anyway, but that's neither here nor there. I digress. Coming back, the German kid comes from a stable family, and in terms of his background, and a Jewish kid who, you know, is Jewish, and, you know, they were being oppressed by the SS, what do they call it? The SS Third Reich, something like that, the Nazis, right? So and then, you know, the kids, they tried to make friends, but they couldn't. And it's very similar to, you know, what happened in South Africa years ago with apartheid. Very similar, right? And the kid, you know, especially in the end, the kid was looking for his friend, ended up inside the gas chambers, and he died, got gassed along with a bunch of other Jews. Which kind of like makes you think that, oh, serves the German kid right for being part of, you know, the for being German, the oppressive Germans, and they were so oppressive that one of their own got gas chambered along with the Jews. You can't help but feel sympathy, as I did as well, watching that. So I grew, most people watching that grew up hating Nazis. Depictions and portrayals are very powerful. And then let's talk about the movie Inside Man. How Clive Owen's character, Dalton Russell, right? They broke in, they pulled off a heist at this bank to expose a very special item. Even though, you know, it's very ingenious how they broke in and they didn't get caught. Denzel Washington's character saw the note at you know, the what do you call this thing? At the, you know the safe deposit lock, the safety deposit lock, right? Safe deposit lock. Only to, you know, find a ring. And it was found that the bank owner, the owner of the bank, had a Nazi past. He was a World War II veteran, and he was a Nazi. And of course, you can't help but like, the bank owner is actually a bad person, because he's a former Nazi veteran soldier who ran away to come to America, and, you know, and then now they're exposing his past. You can't help but like view Nazis in a negative light. But were they monsters really? Because they're trying to program you to have a problem with nationalism. Adolf Hitler was nothing but a proud nationalist, a patriot, just as I am proud of my own country, South Africa. We're a first world African country. And to anyone who wants to be proud of their country, just like Americans, there are flags everywhere. I'm pretty sure if you go to the United States, you'll find flags everywhere. Outside buildings, outside banks, outside schools, and even hot dog stands. I'm pretty sure they'll have like a flag hanging, you know, somewhere. That's how proud Americans are. There's also a very particular American who's very proud of his country as well, that they're trying to frame in a negative light. They've been trying to frame him in a negative light for the longest time, ever since he decided to run for presidential office. They tried to assassinate him twice. The Jews have to spin the narrative of being a nationalist is a bad thing. Because Jews, their mission is to spread out to all first world countries. There'll be United States, you know, America, England, South Africa, Australia, New Zealand. They have dibs and control of all these first world nations. Okay? And that's how, you know, they run our governments. Our own government, our own politicians are not even in charge. Did you know? They're not in charge. The Jews have so much power over and leverage over them. They decide what is hate speech and what is not. They've decided that masculinity is hate speech. I'm a man. Oh, you hate women. No, I don't hate women. I'm just, you know, I'm pro-masculinity. Because that's what keeps societies together. Our entire civilization was built by men. Now they're saying masculinity is bad, so now we need to usher in female empowerment. The opposite. Another narrative they're trying to spew is this whole anti-white agenda. Oh, white people are so racist, so therefore we need to, you know, usher in affirmative action and hire people of color. But the sad thing is, a country ran by people of color does not look the same and does not function the same as a first world country that was built by white people from the ground up. All first world countries were established by whites, including our very own South Africa. We know this. The whites came here, the European settlers came here, the British, the Dutch, and they built South Africa from the ground up to be the beautiful South Africa it is today. Are you offended? Good. That means you're listening. That means I have your undivided attention. Strap on. There's more, because there's more where that came from. You need to hear this. So in order for Jews to seep in and marinate amongst us, they have to create laws that allows for, you know, diversity, equity, and inclusion so that they can seep in and marinate. Because if these first world countries say, no, we are pro-South Africa first, we are pro-America first, they can't move in and start running the show. Because they are Agent Smiths are outsiders. They come from Israel. Israel controls America. Mossad, IDF. They control all these first world countries. As such, you know, whenever Israel decides to bomb its own Hezbollah, the Gaza Strip, America comes and acts as an attack dog on its enemies. Who are the enemies? Afghanistan, Iran, and all other surrounding Middle Eastern countries. And they frame them as terrorists. 9/11. Okay? Israel conducted 9/11. So Israel itself doesn't necessarily fight Afghanistan, Saudi Arabia, Iran, or Iraq by itself. No. It causes trouble, and then it sends America, yeah, boy. And then America comes and does the dirty work for Israel. Do you understand now? This runs very deep, okay? So coming back to, you know, we're living in a time where anyone expresses national pride will be called a Nazi or a Adolf Hitler type of figure. Which I understand the connotation, the negative connotation attached to it, but really for truly it isn't negative. Adolf Hitler was a proud nationalist who did whatever it takes to defend his country. Be proud of your nation. Do not allow
the Antichrist, aka the Jews, aka, what I like to call them, the Agent Smiths of this Matrix, to run the show. I hope this helped you understand. I hope this gave you, like, doses of the red pill. I hope I unprogrammed a lot of you NPCs watching. Yeah. Thank you so much for watching. You've been watching and listening to The Chronicles of a Proud Nationalist. If you've been watching this far, thank you so much for watching. And remember, the Matrix has you. Follow the white rabbit. And don't fall for the psyops. Thank you for watching. Cheers.